Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, the insertion and the action of the flexor carpi radialis muscle. Here we can see the flexor carpi radialis from an anterior view, and you can see it's connecting the humerus to the metacarpals, and we'll be going over the specifics of the origin and insertion in just a moment. Here you can see the right arm from an anterior view, and you can see the flexor carpi radialis highlighted in green. Some other muscles close by to it are the flexor digitorum superficialis, the palmaris longus, the pronator teres, and the brachioradialis. Next, you can see I've got the origin highlighted here in red, and that's on the medial epicondyle of the humerus. And if we move downwards now towards the hand, you can see either side here highlighted in blue, we've got the insertion, and the insertion is on the bases of the second and third metacarpal bones. So let's go over the actions next. So flexor carpi radialis coming down the forearm here and crossing over the wrist joint. So its actions are going to occur at the wrist joint. So let's go over the first one, and the first one's going to be flexion of the wrist. So the wrist is extended at the moment. As that flexor carpi radialis contracts, we got flexion, and we got an indication of what it does in the name, flexor carpi, flexion of the wrist. Now, in addition to wrist flexion, can also assist in wrist abduction. So that's moving the wrist in the direction towards the thumb here. So there we go, that'd be wrist abduction. And it'd be wrist abduction because when the body's in the anatomical position, you can see the thumb is pointing away from the body. So as it contracts, it would be abducted, moving it away from the body. So if you've enjoyed the video or you find it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press these buttons down there because it really helps out the channel. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you all next time.